Hey everybody, it's Friday! Woo! Oh yeah. Oh yeah. My sad attempt at dancing. Let's do this thing! Down to business. Okay, I wanted to say hey to, Liz. You seem like a pretty cool person, so... Welcome to the Mini Seed the Gay. Oh yeah. Okay. So howdy. Howdy everybody. Yeah, howdy. It's Friday, quite obviously. And this week we're talking about whether we did anything gay before we knew it. And as I look back, I did do a lot of gay things. I mean, I always used to play house with, the neighbor girl, and I never realized that we were acting as, like, sisters almost, but we were more lovers than sisters, and I didn't realize the lesbian aspect of it until I actually, like, analyzed it now. I mean, in hindsight, that was pretty gay. Let's see. I've always been kind of more attracted to the masculine kind of girls. I don't know, not like physically or attracted, but like, I mean, like friendship wise. I mean, hey, masculine girls, hey, you're cool with me. So, both ways. But as a kid, I more was drawn towards friendship, so yeah. Let's see. Oh, in second grade, I had a crush on my teacher. And, see, all these memories are coming back up. I had a crush on my teacher, and I was really attracted to her form, like her body and her shapes, and I don't know. But, yeah, that was pretty gay. What else? Oh. This was the best story. One time in like fourth grade, I invited my best friend over for a sleepover. It didn't end up being a sleepover because, I don't know, I think she got scared or something in the middle of the night. So she had to call her parents. But up until that, we turned on the tunes, like the radio or something, and I just started dancing, and she kind of started dancing along, and eventually a slow song came on, so it got kind of awkward because we were just kind of swaying to the beat of the music, like the slow tch-tch-tch of the cymbals, and eventually, I just took her hands and started dancing with her. And at that point, I didn't know my sexuality, but this was like fourth grade. I don't think a lot of, well, unless, I don't know, unless you're like really, really in tune with yourself and everything. But I didn't know at that point. I mean, I knew since second grade that I was attracted to the female form in some way, but not like sexual, obviously, but I don't know. That was a magical moment, and as I look back on it, it just fills me with warmth. I don't know. It's just nice. Let's see. I was always looking for, like, lesbian friends. Yeah, I was. And even though I didn't know who I was inside until a couple years ago, I was always attracted to talking to lesbians, which was strange, but in hindsight, hey, I was attracted to what I saw in them because I saw it in myself. On a subconscious level. So, yeah. There was this, On a totally unrelated note, well, it's kind of related. Everything on this channel is sort of related in some way to the gay community. But anyways, I heard a radio broadcast of, like, I think it was Argentinian men. They were, like, the first Argentinian men to get married. And I just started beaming in the darkness because we were driving, I think we were driving home because my dad had to pick up his car or something like that. So we were driving home and I started beaming. Oh, it was ridiculous. This was only the other night. It wasn't a childhood thing, but oh my gosh. I just had to share that because I felt so much pride and joy. I just started smiling, and I think it's beautiful. Finally, marriage is what we want to do with our lives, too. I mean, we haven't achieved that through equality in U.S. laws, but it's progress, so yeah. Just wanted to share that. So, I'll just say goodbye to you guys, and hope you like this. Comment, and subscribe. I would appreciate that. So, see you guys next Friday on The Many Shades of the Day.